The City Concert Series on today is proudly presented to you by City.
Paid for this. Okay, who is ready to get things started? It's International Women's Day. Maren Morris. She's incredible. And you know what? It wasn't long ago she was playing in bars and writing songs for other people. But now she is taking center stage as one of music's hottest acts.
Take a seat.
She's an established songwriter and country music sensation.
So why don't you just meet me in the middle?
But last year's massive hit, The Middle, made Maren Morris a superstar. The song breaking the record for most weeks at number one on Billboard's Dance Songs chart.
My 80s Mercedes.
Her success didn't come easy. After hitting roadblocks with performing, she started writing music for artists like Tim McGraw and Kelly Clarkson before taking a bold step.
Can I get a hallelujah?
In 2015, she self-released her single, My Church, on Spotify.
Once I'd written My Church, I realized I don't want anyone to sing this except for me.
That song landed Maren a record deal and a number one debut album just 1 year later. Even winning her a Grammy.
Oh, this is so crazy.
We don't want more than anyone else. We want the same as everyone else.
Today, Maren is out with her highly anticipated sophomore album, Girl. And in an industry dominated by men.
Are those the four chords, you know? Because they're really pretty.
Maren is doing her part, working with and mentoring other female musicians. This morning for International Women's Day, Maren Morris is celebrating with girls around the world right here on our City Concert Stage.
Why don't you just meet me in the middle?
We are back on this International Women's Day with a sea of wonderful women on the plaza. We got some great guys here as well.
Oh my God.
Craig and I are thrilled to be here with you guys, and we're so happy to have Maren Morris with us as well. Her second album, Girl, it's out today. It's number one on iTunes. Congratulations.
Yes. And we should point out, Maren is also kicking off her Girl World Tour tomorrow. Maren, good morning.
Good morning.
You are speaking to these women out here. I saw you out here mingling. What does it mean to be out here on this day?
Well, it makes me pretty emotional. It just looks so beautiful out here. There's so many amazing men and women out here celebrating International Women's Day. And so to just be a part of this really special thing
is amazing. I think you're such
amazing.
An inspiration,
yeah.
Maren, because you were someone, you were doing well in Nashville, doing some songwriting, but you found something in yourself. And you were like, you know what? I'm going to be the singer. I'm going to be the one out there.
Yeah, say it
yes,
out loud.
And what was it inside you that allowed you to really get out there, take that risk, and go for your dream?
You know, I just felt like I wasn't seeing enough women in the landscape of the industry, and I felt like I had something really special and unique to say, and maybe others would be inspired by the message. So that's when I put My Church out, and everything that's happened since then has just been so life-changing.
You've been vocal about that in the past, about the lack of women represented in the country music industry there in Nashville. Why do you think that is?
You know, I don't know. There's not this, like, right or wrong reason. I just think the more that we stay silent, the more we're complicit in the fact that there's a problem and nothing's happening about it. So I try to use my platform and just like call on my sisters and like give them the opportunities I was given by others. And so that's all you can really do is take action and not just keep talking about it.
What are you going to sing for us, Maren?
I'm going to sing a new song of mine. It's on my record that came out today. It's called The Bones.
Oh, it's a great one.
All right,
take it away,
Maren.
Take it away.
All right, thank you.
International Women's Day on today is presented to you by City, proud champion of See Her and Women in Music. Hashtag See Her, Hear Her.
And welcome back on this International Women's Day. Our next guest is a Grammy-winning singer and songwriter who flat out rocked the plaza just a few minutes ago here on today. We, of course, are talking about Maren Morris.
Ah, yes. Her new album is called Girl, and it's out right now. Maren, good morning to you.
Hi, morning.
And we just found out congratulations is in order. Your album's now number one on iTunes.
Yeah.
That's amazing. It's just out today.
I know. It's crazy. I'm still kind of processing the good news.
And they just told you this morning.
Yeah, on air, like Savannah and Hoda. Yeah.
You didn't know it was number one until then.
No, I mean, I saw that it was number one on like the country chart, but not overall iTunes. No, I
found out when you pour your heart into something like that, and then you find out like in a moment like this that it's number one. What does that feel like?
It feels kind of surreal just because we've been sitting on these songs for so long. I wrote some of them 4 years ago. So to have them kind of out for the world to consume now and not just for, you know, my husband and I listening in our kitchen. It's crazy to look at numbers like that. I mean, it's not about the numbers. It's about just having the music out for the fans. But it's icing on the cake to have it reach that top spot.
We're going to talk about my favorite Maren Morris song in just a second. But the process, when you're writing a song, how do you go about doing that?
It depends. Sometimes I'll get ideas when I'm driving, and I'll try to, like, record it in my phone really quick before it leaves the ether. And then a lot of times, you know, in Nashville, there's so much co-writing that happens that your friends will bring in titles or concepts or melodies. So I feel like it's a group effort a lot of times. I don't do this alone. I do it with a lot of collaborators. So, yeah, it's just whatever strikes the mood, I guess.
You know what I found fascinating? I was reading up on you, and I was reading about when you used to sometimes write some of your lyrics in like in the back of a tour bus, like you guys are riding around. What was that like?
I had to adapt over the last few years to kind of artist life, and you don't have a ton of time to write at home when you're touring, so I had to just bring my friends to me and write songs in the back lounge, and a lot of this record was written in the back of a bus.
Really?
Yeah.
A few years ago, you wrote a song. It's called Dear Hate. And I just want to play just a few bars of it for our audience at home, because it's...
In the garden, like a snake in the grass. I see you in the morning, staring through the looking glass. You whisper down through history and echo through these halls. But I hate to tell you, love's gonna conquer all.
You wrote that in the wake, as I understand it at least, of that despicable shooting of the church in Charleston.
Yeah.
But you didn't release it until a couple of years later. Why?
The day we wrote that song, Tom Douglas, David Hodges, and I were just kind of reeling from the tragedy of that shooting. And I think that was back in 2015. And it just felt like a song that was ours. It didn't feel like it was meant for the world. It was just a healing process for the three of us. But then my band and I played the Vegas Festival 2 years ago, I guess, a year and a half ago. And we played the night before the shooting. And I just remember waking up to the news like the rest of the world, hearing about, you know, all of these lives lost. And I remembered this song I had written years prior, Dear Hate. And so Vince Gill, who sings on the song with me, who's one of the most beautiful vocalists in the world, we just decided we'd love to release it and give the proceeds from the streams and the downloads to the victims' families. And, you know, just over the years, oh my gosh, even last night I did a thing for YouTube, and there was a fan there that said that she was there that night and she lost her dad. That was their last concert together. And that song, Dear Hate, really helped bring some peace to their family. And to have someone say that about a song you've written is just unfathomable, and, you know, kind of why we do it. It's not why we do it, but it's why we do it, if that makes sense.
You want your music to touch someone.
Absolutely.
You want it to be impactful.
Yeah, Maren, it's medicinal. Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming in. Jen and I were talking earlier this morning, our young girls, you know, belt out your music. They love your music. And then now to meet you in person, you're just such a light.
Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you for coming
and
in.
The velvet?
It works.
Thank you.
Yes.
It all works. Wore it for y'all. That was good with the purple.
Doesn't it, right?
I love these
Happy International Day of the Girl.
Yes.
Or woman.
Oh,
both.
Oh,
whatever.
Yeah.
We'll be right back. Girl power, you too.